Hello students, welcome in the next lecture of integral equations. Okay, so in the previous lecture we are going to study the method for finding the solution of non-homogeneous Friedholm integral equation of second kind with separable kernel and the method is the successive approximations method. Okay, and also we solve examples on that method, that is we find the solution of non-homogeneous Friedholm integral equation of second kind with separable kernel by using method of successive approximations. Okay, then in today's lecture we are going to study the new method, that is the another one method for finding the solution of non-homogeneous Friedholm integral equation of second kind with separable kernel is the method of successive substitution. Okay, in previous lecture we see the method, that is method of successive approximations. Okay, and that is we find, in that method we find the successive approximations, and from that we find the nth successive approximation, and if we take that nth successive approximation at n tends to infinity, then we have to get the solution. Okay, and in today we see the successive substitution method. Okay, that is we have to substitute, we have to take substitution in Friedholm integral equation, then we have to get the solution. Okay, so first to see what is this method. Okay, so in the method of successive substitution we have to set, we have to set x is equal to t and t is equal to t1, that is we have to substitute x is equal to t and t is equal to t1 in the Friedholm integral equation, in the Friedholm integral equation of second kind with separable kernel. So we know that the Friedholm integral equation is u of x is equal to f of x plus lambda integration from a to b k of x t into u of t dt. Okay, so we take this equation as equation number 1. Okay, then in this equation we have to put x is equal to t and t is equal to t1. Okay, so by putting x is equal to t here becomes u of t is equal to f of t plus lambda integration from a to b k of t, x is equal to t and t is becomes t1. So we have to get this kernel will be k of t t1 into u of t1 dt1. Okay, so this equation becomes in this, so we have to get, this is the value of u of t, then again we put this u of t in equation number 1, that is in standard Friedholm integral equation. Okay, so by substituting this in equation number 1, then equation number 1 becomes a u of x is equal to f of x, that is here we have to, under this integral sign unknown function u of t occurs, so instead of here we have to put this value. Okay, that is substitute this value plus lambda integration from a to b k of x t will be as it is, and instead of this u of t we have to put this. Okay, so we write in bracket these terms, f of t plus lambda integration from a to b k of t t1 into u of t dt1. Okay, and so this bracket will be complete into k of x t, this k of x t into this u of t dt. Okay, so we can simplify this. So we have to get f of x plus lambda integration from a to b k of x t. Here again if you observe,
k of x t into we write this f of t into this u of t dt. Okay, so k of x t f of t into u of t dt. Okay, we multiply this in the bracket and also we separate this integral to each term. And here this lambda into lambda becomes a lambda square. This integral becomes a double integral from a to b, a to b. Here k of x t will be as it is kernel into this kernel k of t t1 u of t. Sorry, here will be the u of t1. So we have to get here u of t1 into this u of t. Not u of t, sorry, again we can take here mistake. Okay, so here only the dt because we put here value of u of t. Okay, so can't write the u of t, only write dt. Okay, so this is we have to get u of x. Okay, by taking this substitution x is equal to t and t is equal to t1. Okay, then in next step we have to put put x is equal to t1 and t is equal to t2. Okay, then we have to put x is equal to t1 and t is equal to t2 in equation number 1. Okay, in equation number, if we put x is equal to t1 and t is equal to t2 in equation 1, from that we have to get value of u t1, then we have to put u of t1 in this equation. So take this equation as the equation number 2. Okay, so by putting x is equal to t1 and t is equal to t2 in equation number 1, equation number 1 becomes u of t1 is equal to f of t1, okay, plus lambda integration from a to b k of t1 t2, because x is equal to t1 and t is equal to t2 we can put. Okay, and here we have to get u of t2, here will be dt2. Okay, so we have to get here value of ut1, then we have to put ut1 in equation number 2. Okay, then put ut1 in equation number 2. Okay, so equation number 2 becomes this will be the equation number 2. LHS will be u of x, then in RHS f of x plus lambda integration from a to b k of x t into f of t dt. Okay, then next term is lambda square double integral from a to b k of x t into second kernel k of t t1. Okay, then u of t1, here we have to put value of u of t1 will be this, so we write in the bracket. Okay, so we write here this value, that is f of t1 plus lambda integration from a to b k of t1 t2 into ut2 dt2. Okay, so bracket complete and into this dt. Okay, dt and do dt1. Okay, so again if we simplify this, then we have to get f of x plus lambda integration from a to b k of x t into f of t dt. Those two terms as it is. Then this, if we separate this integral and multiply this inside the bracket, so we have to get here lambda square double integral from a to b k of x t into k of t t1, okay, into this f of t1 dt into dt1. Okay,
or we write this as d1 into dt.
Okay. And plus this, we separate this. This lambda square into this lambda becomes a lambda cube, and this double integral into this will be becomes a triple integral from a to b. Okay. So triple integral from a to b, this kernel will be as it is k of x t, then k of t t1, then k of t1 t2, okay, into this ut2 and dt2 dt1 and dt. Okay, so in this way we have to get the next term. Okay, by taking the substitution, x is equal to t1 and t is equal to t2, from that we have to get value of ut1. So we put that value in above equation in this, and then we have to get the next next term. Okay, so if we continue in this way, here again we have to get u of t2. So again in equation number 1, here if we put x is equal to t2, x is equal to t2 and t is equal to t3, x is equal to t2, t is equal to t3, so we have to get the value of ut2 from this. So we put again value of ut2 here. Okay, and then we have to get the next term. So in this way we have to find the next terms. Okay, so if we continue this process, then we have to get the some infinite series. Okay, so we find the solution, that is continue, if we use this substitution process, then we have to get the infinite geometric series or a Taylor series, and then we find the solution of that series or of that integral equation by using the sum of infinite geometric series or a Taylor series. You can see that in first chapter how to find the sum of infinite geometric series and by using Taylor series how to reduce the expansion or how to write the function of that series. Okay, so before or sorry so after that process we have to use the infinite geometric series or a Taylor series, depends on that series. Okay, and then we have to get the solution. Okay, so we see here one example to clear the concept of or to clear the method of successive substitution. Okay, so we take, you see here one example first. So I can here example, that is the non-homogeneous Friedel integral equation of second kind with separable kernel. Okay, so by comparing this equation first with the standard form, then we have to get here f of x will be equal to 23 divided by 6 into x. Okay, lambda will be equal to 1 by 8 and kernel k of x t will be is equal to x into t. Okay, so we find the solution by using substitution. So by using successive substitution method. Okay, so in successive substitution method we have to not apply each term or each steps, that is we can see in theory, that is we have to directly consider this series. Okay, or this term, and then from that we have to put here the value and to obtain the geometric series. Okay, so if we continue this series, then we can write this as u of x will be equal to f of x, or here also we have to get plus dash 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 dash. Okay, so here if we observe the each term of this if we observe here each term of this equation, then in first lambda, first will be f of x, then second will be lambda a to b k of x t, and here f of t dt, that is the unknown function of the standard Friedel integral equation which is replaced by the function f of t. Okay, then in second term lambda square, that is lambda square double integral k of x t, k of t t1, f of t1, dt1, dt. Okay. Again, unknown function is replaced by f of t1, and here kernel will be added t a t t1. That is in terms of t and t1. So in this way, we have to get the next terms or increase in this way these terms. So we can directly write this equation, and from that we can find the solution. Okay. Successive substitution method. U of x, that is solution, will be in the form u of x is equal to f of x plus lambda integration from a to b k of x t into f of t dt. Okay, then lambda square integration from a to b double integral, okay, k of x t k of t t1 f of t1, okay, and here dt1 into dt. Okay, and the fourth term will be lambda cube triple integral from a to b, okay, k of x t k of t t1 k of t t1 t2, okay, then f of, we have to get, if we put here we can't find the value of u of t2. If we find the next term, then we have to get here instead of u of t2, that is the f of t2, okay, dt2, dt1 and dt, okay, plus dash dash dash, because we have to get in this way the infinite terms in the solution. Okay, so we put here values f of x, lambda, limits and kernel. Okay, so f of x will be here 23 divided by 6 into x. Okay, lambda will be 1 by 8, limits from 0 to 1. Then kernel k of x t will be x into t f of t dt. F of x will be 23 divided by 6 into x. So f of t will be 23 divided by 6 into t, okay, into dt plus. Then for this term lambda square, lambda will be 1 by 8. So lambda square 1 by 8 square double integral from 0 to 1. Okay. K of x t again x into t. Again, so see here k of x t will be x into t. Then k of t t1, from that k of t t1 we have to replace here, x is equal to t and t is equal to t1 in this kernel. So this kernel becomes say is equal to t into t1. Okay. So k of t t1 we get t into t1. Okay. Into f of t1. F of x will be this. So f of t1 will be 23 divided by 6 into, in the instead of x, t1. Okay. Then here dt1 dt. Okay. Then we write this fourth term, lambda cube, that is 1 by 8 cube, okay, then triple integral from 0 to 1, okay, k of x t, that is again x into t, then k of t t1, x is equal to t and t is equal to t1, so t into t1, and again here k of t1 t2, that is x is equal to t1 and t1 is equal to t2. So we have to get kernel will be t1 t2, because we have to put x is equal to t1 and t is equal to t2. Okay. And f of t2 is 23 divided by 6 into x instead of x we have to put t2. So this will be f of t2, then dt2, dt1, dt. Okay. And plus up to so on. Okay. Then we simplify this or find the first integral. Okay, so 23 divided by 6 into x plus 1 by 8 plus 1 by 8 into, we take this 23 divided by 6 into, this x will be outside because which is the constant with respect to t. Then in integration, remaining only integration from 0 to 1, t into t becomes a t square dt. Okay. Similarly here, 1 by 8 bracket square
Again x is constant, 23 by 6 will be constant. So we take outside, that is 23 by 6 into x, double integral from 0 to 1. And in integration, this t into t becomes a t square into this. T1 into t1 becomes a t1 square dt1 dt. Okay. And for this last third term, not last term, we can write here plus 1 by 8 bracket cube. Again here 23 by 6 into this x will be constant. So we take outside 23 divided by 6 into x. Triple integral from 0 to 1. Okay. Then see here t into t becomes a t square. T1 into t1 becomes a t1 square. Okay. And this t2 into t2 becomes a t2 square into dt2, dt1 and dt plus up to dash dash dash. Okay. Then we find this double integral, single integral and triple integral. Triple integral and simplify to get the sum geometric or in Taylor series. Okay. So 23 divided by 6 into x first term will be as it is plus 1 by 8, that is we write 23 divided by or we write these terms will be as it is because we have to take some sequence. So 23 by x plus 1 by 8 into 23 divided by 6 into x, we can write as it is. Then integration of t square will be t cube divided by 3 from 0 to 1. Okay. Then next term 1 by 8 bracket square. Okay. Plus, sorry, not plus, into 23 divided by 6 into x. And integration from 0 to 1. So see here, first we can take integration with respect to dt1. Okay, so we can write this integral 0 to 1, t square will be as it is, integration of t1 square will be t1 cube divided by 3, limits from 0 to 1 into dt. Okay. Then plus, similarly for this term 1 by 8 cube 23 divided by 6 into x. Okay. Plus, sorry, not plus. Again here integration from 0 to 1, 0 to n, double integral. We can take first integral with respect to from first dt2. Okay. So here t square t1 square will be as it is because with which are constant with respect to t2. Okay. So integration of t2 square will be t2 cube divided by 3 from 0 to 1 and here will be dt1 dt. Okay. Then plus up to dash dash dash. Okay. So we have to get 23 divided by 6 into x plus 1 by 8 into 23 divided by 6 into x. Okay. Then if we put here limits, 1 cube will be 1. So 1 by 3 minus 0 by 3. Okay. Then plus 23 divided by 6 into x. Again, here by putting limits 0 to 1 t square, by putting limits we get 1 by 3 minus 0 by 3 into this dt. Okay. Then plus this term 1 by 8 bracket cube 23 divided by 6 into x, double integral from 0 to 1 as it is, and t square t1 square will be as it is. Then again here putting limits 1 by 3 minus 0 by 3 dt1 dt plus up to dash dash dash. Okay. So 23 divided by 6 into x plus 1 by 8, 23 divided by 6 into x. Okay. Then here this term becomes a 0, so remaining only into 1 by 3. Okay. Plus 23 divided by 6 into x And here again this will be 0, is here remaining only 1 by 3. So we take that 1 by 3 outside from integration, which is constant. So 1 by 3 in integration 0 to 1 t square dt. Okay, t square into dt. Okay, and plus this term 1 by 8 bracket cube into 23 divided by 6 into x. Here again 1 by 3 will be constant with respect to t, so we take outside t1 and t, and in integration double integral 0 to 1 remaining only t square t1 square dt1 dt. Okay, so we can again take the integral 23 divided by 6 into x, plus here 8 into 3 will be 24, so 1 by 24 again 23 divided by 6 into x. We can write this 23 by 6 will be as it is, because we have to take this 23 by 6 which is present in all the terms, so we have to take this will be outside, so we can't take the product of these with respect to another terms, we write will be as it is. Okay, so the in next term 23 divided by 6 into x into this 1 by 3. Okay, integration of t square will be t cube divided by 3, limits from 0 to 1. Okay, plus 1 by 8 cube 23 divided by 6 into x. Okay, into this 1 by 3. And again here we take the integral with respect to t1 first. T will be as it is with respect to constant, which is constant with respect to t1. So we write as it is. So integration of t1 square will be t1 cube divided by 3, limits from 0 to 1, and here t square dt. Okay. So it's equal to 23 divided by 6 into x plus 1 divided by 24 into 23 divided by 6 into x plus 23 divided by 6 into x. Again here by putting limits 1 by 3 minus 0 by 3. Okay, plus 1 by 8 cube 23 divided by 6 into x. Okay, then this 1 by 3 integration from 0 to 1, if we put here limits we get 1 by 3 minus 0 by 3 t square dt, here plus up to dash dash dash, because we have to get here infinite terms in the solution. Okay, so 23 divided by 6 into x plus 1 by 24, 23 divided by 6 into x plus 23 divided by 6 into x, 1 by 3 into 3 will be 9. Okay, so we have to get here 1 by 9 plus 1 by 8 cube 23 divided by 6 into x, is 1 by 3 into 1 by 3. Okay, this will be 0. And again here integration of t square will be, we can write directly t cube divided by 3 from 0 to 1 with respect to t, plus up to dash dash dash. Okay, then next to get, we have to get u of x is equal to 23 divided by 6 into x plus 23 divided by 6 into x 1 by 24 plus 23 by 6 plus x plus 1 by 24, sorry, into 1 by 24 plus 23 divided by 6 into x into 1 by 8 square into 1 by 9. Okay, plus 1 by 8 cube into 23 divided by 6 into x. Okay, plus 1 by 3 into 1 by 3 will be 1 by 9, and we put the limits we get 1 by 3 minus 0 by 3 plus up to dash dash dash. Okay, again by simplifying we get 23 divided by 6 into x plus 23 divided by 6 into x into 1 by 24. Again we write here square of 1 by 8 That is 1 by 8 square will be 1 by 64 into 1 by 9, 23 divided by 6 into x. We can write as it is, okay? Plus 1 by 8 cube into these 1 by 9 and this 1 by 3. 9 into 3 will be 1 by 27, okay? Into this 23 by 6 into x. Plus up to so on, okay? So is equal to 23 divided by 6 into x. So here if we observe all the terms, that is we have to find, that we can find all the term contains 23 by 6 into x. So we can take outside from these terms. So we get 1 plus, here will be remaining 1 plus 1 by 24 plus 24 and plus here 23 by 6 into x will be outside and here 64 into 9 will be 576, okay, plus here 1 by 8 cube, that is 1 by 512 into 1 by 27 plus up to so on, okay. So we have to get this will be the infinite geometric series in the bracket. Okay, so we can find the sum of this infinite geometric series. Using the sum of infinite geometric series, we find the sum of this series and then we multiply here this sum to get the solution. Okay, so we have to get here u of x is equal to 23 divided by 6 into x in bracket 1 plus 1 by 24 plus 1 divided by 576, 9216, okay, plus up to so on, plus 1 upon 9216 plus up to so on, okay. So here if we observe this series from infinite geometric series in bracket, in this bracket here a1 is equal to 1, okay, r will be the constant ratio, will be equal to 1 by 24. So we have to get the sum. S is equal to, we know the formula for finding the sum, s is equal to a1 divided by 1 minus r. So is equal to a1 will be 1 divided by 1 minus 1 by 24 is equal to, we get 1 divided by, here by taking cross multiplication, 24 minus 1 divided by 24. So we have to get 24 becomes in numerator. So we have to get 24 divided by 23. Okay. So this we have to get the sum of this infinite geometric series. So we put this sum in equation number, in above equation to get the solution. Okay. Okay. So by putting this sum in u of x, put s in u of x to get u of x is equal to 23 divided by 6 into x into, instead of that geometric series we can write their sum, that is 24 divided by 23. Okay, so this 23 gets cancelled, we have to get u of x is equal to here 6 4s are 24. So here we have to get solution will be u of x is equal to 4x. Okay, so in this way we can find the solution by using the successive substitution method. Okay, so if we see this method here, the number of calculations will be complicated. Rarely use this method. Okay, if we have to find the solution of non-homogeneous Riemann integral equation of second kind with separable kernel, then most commonly method used, that is the direct substitution method, which is the very easiest method. Okay, okay. So today we stop here. Thank you.